Can you imagine that one day, President Abe will deliver a speech in English? Not in New York, not in Panama, but right here in Taiwan, in Taichung, right now. Ladies and gentlemen, this is President Abe. Dear Toastmasters, this is my pleasure to address in your whole convention. That your whole convention will be Power Hall, Subset Hall, and Art Hall. Do you think it's hard to imagine? That dream may become the possibility, and this imagination may become the reality very soon. Because our premier, Yao Xikun, he said that in 2008, English will be our second official language. Do you still think it's impossible? At that time, some of our government officers, they will have to speak English as a basic requirement. Wow, think twice. But what does ESL really mean? Apart from English as a second language, it also means that teaching non-native speakers in an English-speaking country. What kind of country? That's Singapore or America. When you think of those two countries, who flashed into your mind as a representative? Oi, our beloved Taipei mayor, Angel Ma. He went to America to complete his PhD. So of course he has good command of English. His English may be like this. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Angel Ma, the Taipei mayor, and I am the angel of charisma. People from all walks of life love me, particularly women. Let's gather this women power and make Taipei an in city. Oh, if you want to support me, please do write to me or email to me. Oh, here, I got some email. Oh, this one is Athena Vian. Oh, thank you for email and your encouragement. And I've been placed you into our club. Your number is 80,888. Oh, thank you. That's another love letter. Letter from Sheila Chow. Sheila, thank you for your admiration. I love you too. And your number I assign you, 80,889. Welcome to join Ma Zhen. Okay, but a lot of us, we are not as lucky as Angel Ma. We study English in Taiwan. Taiwan is a foreign country. So we call that EFL, English as a Foreign Language. It also means that we learn English, we are the non-native speakers, and we learn English in a non-English speaking country, such as Taiwan and Japan. Taiwan, Japan, Taiwan, Japan. What refresh into your mind? Oh, baseball. No. That's our beloved former president, Uncle Abe. Okay, his English is quite Sakura style. He was speaking this way. I tell you, Taiwan is one independent country, not a part of PROC. And Taiwan is Taiwan. China is China. One country, one side. You know, God bless you, Taiwan. Hallelujah. Okay. Who are you? The category, ESL or EFL? Perhaps let's ask our next generation. Are they proceeding to ESL? October 31st this year, a reporter went to Chiang Kai-shek Memorial and to interview a few kids. Well, there were two kids over there.
One dressed up beautifully. The other one dressed up ugly. Okay, so the reporter says, Hi, 小朋友. The kid says, Shh, no Chinese. Otherwise, my teacher, Ron, will give you $5 fine. Okay, how are you? What's your name?
My name is Sheila. I am an angel.
And her name is Louisa. She's a witch. Oh, you know what day is today?
Today is October 31st, Halloween.
Oh, do you know whose birthday is today?
Birthday?
It's not my birthday today. Lisa, is it your birthday today? Maybe that's Roger's birthday. He is our ghost.
Oh, this reporter, he just gave up. He says,
Dear audience,This is Dora reporting, and that's it's our reporting for Halloween. It's our reporting for the Chiang Kai-shek's birthday anniversary. But seems that those kids, they know Halloween more than our Chiang Kai-shek's anniversary. Scary, right? Wow. Those kids, they were conditioned and modified in English when they were really young. So when they grow up, they're going to tell you, Daddy,No Chinese. Auntie, uncle, no Chinese. We have to speak English. So do you still think English in 2008 is impossible? Right. Okay, Toastmaster. We are trained to totally master English as our language school. So what do we have to do? We have to reach out and prosper. Let's add an apostrophe here. All the Toastmasters can stand up and yell out, ESL for Toastmasters. I am possible. Okay, return my Toastmasters.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. What speech impressed you by most beginning? I think the speaker's appearance. The topic is ESL impossible and the speaker dressing.Chinese suit. I think she gives the answer. It's impossible. However, she changed this kind of image. She imitates Sakura English, President Chen style English, or Osama Bin Laden's English. All of this show that she is confident, show that she is good at delivery. Besides, her well-elaborate props, visuals, show that how much she showed the respect to audience.I think she must prepare it for a couple of days before. So, all this make audience feel, yes, this is a nice speech. However, my recommendation also will start from this, visual aids. Actually, visual aids has a trade-off with your delivery. Because if your visual aids is good, it's large, everyone can see clear,then it may limit your range of body movement, or you will be over-dependent on it. For example, Dora, you just put your hands here and move around here, but I think this is a big stage, then you can stretch out your hand like this. However, you didn't. So maybe you are afraid of your body movement will cover your visual aids. So maybe only use visual aids on appropriate point. That means the point you really want to emphasize.I think for ESL, English second language, this word, if you say directly, people also can catch it. For Taiwan, Singapore, such words, we know it. Use visual aids only when you explain some abstract concept or some words that's really difficult that audience to catch. And second, I would like to recommend on your structure. Because in the beginning, you talk about thatIs EL same language is almost impossible. For example, Osama Bin Laden or Mayor Moss example. You give the proposal, and however, you didn't give the solution completely. You just tell us that Toastmaster is one of solution. It is possible. But did you explain why it is possible? Because it's full time you use English, or you practice every week.Give more detailed explanation why the solution is useful and does work. I think that will make your speech better. And generally speaking, your delivery, your vocal variety in imitating the little girl, what's your name? I think that all show your good preparation, you are competent. But all the things that I think you have to care about is the usage of visual aids and the structure. And generally speaking, I love your speech because I am the one who proved that learning English in Toastmaster is possible. And nice job, Dora.
Contest master, ladies and gentlemen. Is Dora an officer from the Minister of Education? Or is Dora an English teacher? Or is Dora trying to sell an English speaking cassette to all the audience? Why would I take this kind of guess of her job? Because she has demonstrated very, very good English speaking skills. And also, he's trying to persuade us there's a policy of English as second language in our country. She made her points very clear and very vividly by the example of her self-demonstration. And also, she makes the points of the policy very clear with some facts from the government policy. Although Dora gave us four examples, and including three examples from the politicians. However, I would think those examples from the politician are unnecessary because they demonstrated very, very poor English speaking skills. In the contrary, Dora demonstrated a very, very good English speaking skills as a different example. However, this kind of contraction also tells us the points of our English speaking level right this moment in our countries, and the goal for us is 2008 to achieve English as a second language. In trying to persuade someone or to selling an idea, it's very important to tell the audience 5 W's: who, when, where, why, and how. Does Dora tell us who is going to become this country? Yes, she did, Taiwan. Does Dora tell us when should we go there? Yes, she did. However, she didn't tell us why and how. You see, our public figures, they speak lousy English at this moment. How are we able to achieve at that stage? What's the policy or what's the reason? Why? Maybe we should learn more about that, because for a learner to achieve a better goal, he must know the reason and he must know why. If I want to say a word for Dora's speech, for today's speech, I would say this is a speech of fun. Did you laugh? Did you enjoy it? Yes, she has made a very successful speech with a talented skills in delivery, vocal variety, body gestures, and also use a very, very good examples. I am looking forward to hear Dora's speech in the next time, and I'm also looking forward to offer an opportunity to become a business partner with Dora to sell some English speaking materials. Contact master.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It's my honor to stand here before you to evaluate Laura's speech. Laura did an excellent job in both her content preparation and the actual delivery of her speech. She used a very attention-capturing opening by asking us, what if our president, Mr. Chen Shui-bian, delivered his speeches in English? So everybody laughed. That was good. And she varied her voice accordingly to mimic our president and former president when they speak English. And that was truly funny. Also, she used visual aids very effectively. The posters were huge. Everybody can see clearly, including myself. Now, however, as with any good speeches, there is always room for improvement. I have some personal suggestions for her. Suggestion number one, I think it would be better if she could add a purpose statement in your opening so that I know what your overall purpose is. It was great, but I didn't get your message until the last poster. Suggestion number two, I think it would be better as well if you could organize the body of your speech more logically and present them in point forms for easier comprehension for audience. Suggestion number three, because it was such a wonderful speech and you were so fluent at delivering it, you were going a little bit fast. If you could allow some pauses between points, they would have helped me in understanding you and catching up with your great ideas better. All in all, I quite enjoyed your speech and I appreciate your technique of promoting our Toastmaster Club and promoting English by ridiculing how funny our two presidents spoke English. Now, allow me to say congratulations. It's been a pleasure for me. Contest here.